Franny K. Stein, Earth Scientist, Book 9, Recipe for Disaster, Chapter 12, Smart Cookies Don't Crumble. Franny dug through a box of inventions. I have no idea what to do. I mean, my octagoner will turn the Muffin Man into an octopus, but what if that lets him bake things 4 times as fast? She wondered. I could just launch him to the moon in a rocket, but the kids all know the recipe now, and they'll just keep making muffins on their own, and I am not sending all those kids to the moon with him. I suppose I could just lock them all down there in the basement, and at least they couldn't give muffins to anybody else, but that wouldn't be fair. It's not really their fault. I've always known how to fight great big monsters, but this is different. Franny sat down and looked at a painting that Igor had done of himself and smiled. I guess he'll never paint one for one of me now, she said sadly. Wait a second, she said. Even if I can't convince them to get rid of those muffins, I might know who can. And in a flash, Franny was running back to the school basement. Chapter 13. Have you seen the Muffin Man? In the short time Franny had been gone, the muffins were already piling up in the lobby and spilling out the doors of the school. It wouldn't be long before the Muffin Man really did have enough for the whole world. She made her way back down into the basement. Looks like you are really cooking, she said with a nervous laugh. Igor whirled around and eyed her suspiciously. Muffins were all that mattered to him now, and he knew that Franny could be very tricky. I brought a special helmet, Franny said, pulling the invention out of her backpack. It will let us download all of your awesome baking skills into the brains of all your helpers here. That sounds wonderful, the Muffin Man said. Who should go first? Oh, anybody, I guess, Franny said. How about Mona? Igor let out a low growl. Franny positioned the helmet on top of Mona's head and smiled at the Muffin Man. Pretty soon she'll be almost as good at baking as you, she said. Mona smiled at Franny and said, That's perfect. I always wanted to be a muffin maker. I thought you always wanted to be an artist, Franny whispered to her, and she shrugged. Igor began to move toward them. Franny leaned close so that nobody but Mona could hear her. Mona, this is my visualizer helmet. When I turn this on, you're going to get a look at the future that awaits you. You're going to see what these muffins will bring you. I'll bet it's going to be great, Mona said. Now visualize your future, Mona, Franny said, and she flipped the switch. Mona saw herself as a teenager, making muffins and selling them to people. She did not look very happy. As the helmet hummed, she saw farther into the future. She looked even worse. She was alone, and her brushes and canvases were unused in the corner. She looked sick. She saw her little brother and her friends eating the muffins, and never accomplishing much more than that. She got older and older, but it never got better. A tear rolled down her cheek. You're right, I did want to be an artist, she whimpered. Franny took the helmet off her. Franny, I don't want to do this anymore. I don't want to do this to myself. Just keep these thoughts to yourself for now, Franny told her softly, and go get Vincent. Soon Vincent was visualizing his future. He wasn't a musician. He wasn't really anything. He was just an unhappy adult who had sold his flute to buy muffins. Franny took off the helmet and told him to do just as Mona had done, and to bring another kid over. But then Franny heard Igor behind her, snarling. "You know that I'm up to something, don't you?" she said, reaching for a muffin.
"You're right, Igor. I am. I figured out how to make these muffins even better," she said,
and she dropped one into the helmet. He was still suspicious, but he knew that Franny was smart enough to make anything better.
"Just try it," she said,
and she held out the helmet like it was his old familiar dog dish. Igor sniffed cautiously, and then slowly stuck his face into the helmet. Suddenly, Franny pulled it over his head and turned it on. Igor saw his future. He was an old dog now, missing some teeth, and living on the streets. He limped along, whining and groaning. He had no home, no muffins, and worst of all, no Franny.
"No Franny."
He pulled his head out of the helmet. He couldn't look at her. He was ashamed of himself.
"I'm so sorry, Franny."
Franny hugged him.
"It's okay," she said. "You understand now?"
Igor nodded.
"Yes, I understand it now."
Franny snuck around, carefully putting the helmet on each kid, revealing to them what their future would hold if they kept eating the muffins. Their hopes of being doctors, lawyers, athletes, dancers. The muffins destroyed all of those dreams. Each kid tore off their apron and threw their spoon in the mixing bowl.
"We quit," they shouted.